Hello and welcome back to Crazy Hank TV. Today we're going to review the show Yellowstone, starring Kevin Costner. Now I know some of you are thinking, hey CH, that show's been on for 3 years. You're just now getting around to reviewing it. I just got around to watching it. My wife and I binged it in about 4 days. We really enjoyed it. It just flew by. We went to watch the next episode. You know, it's one of those great binging shows. I will say this, though, a few things. How anyone on this, because no one's happy. Nobody on this show is happy. There is nobody. Everyone is miserable. They're unhappy. Well, the first two seasons, everyone's miserable. But it's filmed in Montana. It's a 200,000-acre ranch in Montana. And everyone in this family who lives on this ranch is miserable. Kevin Costner, who plays John Dutton, the first two seasons is unlikable. I don't think he's ever been in anything where you're supposed to not like him. I just don't like him. There's nothing about him where you go, no, I don't like him. His kids, Beth, for example, is the worst human being on earth, but we start seeing why she is the way she is and how she became so miserable as a person. Because Beth and Jamie hate each other. Just hate each other. Well, we find out in season three why Beth hates Jamie so much. Again, the show is just, I really like it. I really enjoy it. But season three, they start getting us to like a few characters. We start to like Kevin Costner, John Dutton. We start to like Beth a little bit. Casey, we always kind of like Casey, to be honest with you. We always rooted for him. Jamie, we never really liked him. You know, something about his hair. I don't know what it is about his hair. My wife and I both say, what is, and I usually don't criticize people with hair because I don't have hair, but there's something about his hair I don't like. But I'm going to give you some spoilers. Oh, not spoilers. I'm going to give you my theories on season four. These are my theories because at the end, if you haven't seen it, you should watch it. Go back and watch it. Stop right here. Come back and hear my theories on what's going to happen in season four. Now, as we leave the final episode, we find out that John Dutton's been shot. Beth has been blown up. Casey, someone's broken in and has a machine gun. Are they alive? Are they dead? And of course, our first thought is it's got to be Jamie because Jamie inherits everything if those three die. And I'm thinking, yeah, it's got to be Jamie, got to be Jamie. But remember the rule of the Godfather. Who was the first person they killed when they went after the Godfather? Luca Brasi. Why? Because Luca Brasi wouldn't have stopped at anything to get revenge on the people that killed the Godfather. They didn't shoot Rip. Now, we do have that phone call between Rip and Jamie that says, you know, I don't think you should call me anymore. Got to do something with my hair. And so what we all assume, but see, Jamie knows two things. That if he kills those three, he's dead man walking because Rip's not going to stop until he gets him. Also, Rip knows that Jamie killed somebody. So there's no way Jamie is going to let those people, is going to let Rip leave with that information. There's no way. There is just no chance he's going to do it. We think it could be Thomas Rainwater behind it. I don't think so. I just don't think he would go after Casey like that. And there's other people. Yeah, Rourke Morris, who's played by Josh Holloway. I think he's involved in it. I think he's involved in it. This is who I think is behind it all. And I'm going to say it's Governor Perry. And people are like, Governor Perry, where'd this come from? She had a relationship with John Dutton. Well, we have the scene where they're all kind of getting ready, and we see the governor. Look, she doesn't say anything. She's just looking in the mirror, like reflecting on what's going to happen. It just, to me, it's just too obvious what's going to happen. Maybe her family's been threatened. Maybe she's power hungry. She wants to be reelected, and she knows in order to get reelected, she has to go along with what they want to do. And then we find out that Jamie is adopted. Now, out of the blue, he has to go get his proof of birth certificate. I'm sure that, because we said John Dutton and the mayor, I'm sorry, the governor had a relationship. They weren't in love, but they had a relationship. I'm sure at one point or another, he mentioned that Jamie was adopted. She knew this. And she wanted to put a wedge between Jamie, even a bigger wedge between Jamie and the rest of his family. So that's who I'm going to say it is. I'm going to say it's Rourke Morris. I'm going to say it's Morris, the governor, and that are behind all this because they didn't know that they needed to go after Rip. That's the clue. That's why we know it's not Jamie. It's not Jamie. They want us to believe it's Jamie, but I'm telling you right now, it is not Jamie. Jamie didn't do it. Jamie was not behind this because he would have killed. Rip would have been the first person shot. That's all I got. Thanks for watching. If you haven't seen Yellowstone, go watch it. You're going to enjoy it. It's fun. Beautiful scenery. I mean, I want to move to Montana myself. That's all I got. I'm out. Bye, everybody.